zoo rules. Before studying the zoo rules, there is a need to study the history of zoo, that how they are made, what was the condition of the animals before proper laws and reinforcement agencies. So it begins in 19th and 20th century. In 19th and early 20th century, there were only a few number of animal collections, and these collections were from around the world. These collections, they are either captured by certain humans, obviously, and they were either captured by Victorian explorers, or these animals are actually gifts in terms of the diplomatic favor. Because when we move various countries, if you are a diplomatic figure, hai, as a part of gift, किसी एक मुल्क कोई एक मुल्क अपना इम्पोर्टेंट कोई भी चीज़ किसी दूसरे मुल्क को प्रेजेंट कर सकता है. तो इस कॉन्टेक्स्ट में अगर हम देखें वेरियस स्पीशीज़ को, वेरियस एनिमल स्पीशीज़ को एक जगह से दूसरी जगह सेंड किया जाता रहा जस्ट एज गिफ्ट और अ फेवर. 1950s का दौर इज कंसीडर्ड टू बी बूम इन द एरिया ऑफ जू. So they could be called the time period may be called as a zoo boom. In 1950s there was a zoo boom because the entrepreneurs or the financial supporters, the industrialists or the businessmen, actually they get the idea that these animals when displayed they gives a lots of money along with the recreation. So they made a lot of zoos in this context. At that time, entrepreneurs recognized the potential money to be made from exhibiting wild animals to safety public curiosity. Until the 20th century, there was little or no concern of the welfare of the zoo animals. This was actually, you can say, a black era in this regard, that we captured the animals without taking care of them. कई ह्यूमंस को एनिमल्स हैंडलिंग में एनिमल नॉन ह्यूमन केयर के साथ देखा गया है, जिसकी वजह से एनिमल वेलफेयर के बहुत ज़्यादा इश्यूज डेवलप होते हैं. सो एनिमल्स को कैप्चर तो कर लिया जाता है फॉर द बिजनेस पर्पजेज, मगर उनकी केयर नहीं परफॉर्म की जाती. सो इसलिए इस दौर को ब्लैक दौर भी कहा जा सकता है, ये ब्लैक इरा भी कहा जा सकता है विद रेफरेंस टू द एनिमल वेलफेयर. It was until the late 1970s and early 1980s, zoo began to change to reflect the public opinion. Because logon ko ye pata chalna shuru ho gaya that human and animals, they are interacting in various aspects. Human-animal interaction is very important to every walk of life. And we are... In majority of the cases, we are dependent on various type of wild animals in terms of medicines, in terms of the leather, in terms of other aspects like meat. The animals are hunted for their trophies. So their welfare is also very important in this regard. People were then educated about the true conditions endured by the zoo animals. There were seminars for the establishment of welfare of the animals. इस purpose के लिए जब तक लोगों को educate नहीं किया जाएगा या लोगों को educate नहीं इस हवाले से किया जाएगा तब तक हम animals की protection नहीं perform कर सकते. So उस दौर में लोगों को educate किया गया, लोगों को बार बार zoos visit करवाए गए, various तरह के lectures perform करवाए गए, various video conferencing करवाई गई ताकि लोग एनिमल्स को उसी तरह केयर करें जिस तरह वो अपनी केयर करते हैं. नाउ द टुडे स्टेटस ऑफ जू, दैट जूज एग्जिस्ट इन टुडे सोसाइटी फॉर मायराइड्स ऑफ रीजनिंग. देयर आर मल्टीपल रीजंस दैट व्हाई वी केयर दीज एनिमल्स, व्हाई वी मेंटेन द जूज, एंड द मेजर रीजंस आर द कंजर्वेशन, एजुकेशन, साइंस एज वेल एज रिक्रिएशन. Proponents of the animal rights, however, argue that the zoo reinforce the notion of animal domination over non-human animals, which is never beneficial to the animals. This is a very important aspect. There are certain people who say that humans, they dominate over animals. Or jab humans animals ke upar bahut zyada asar andaaz honge to wo unko overkill karenge, unki hunting karenge, unke sath bura saluk karenge. There is a persecution of animals for multiple reasons, and the animals, obviously they feel bad on it. They may get injured. So jo animal rights ko propose karne wale log hain, wo is cheez ko kabhi bhi acha nahi samajhte ki human aur animals ka interaction bahut zyada develop ho, particularly wild animals ka. The existing laws are insufficient to protect the welfare of animals kept in captivity. They also argue that the currently existing laws, they are insufficient, that they protect the animals, particularly which are in enclosures or in captive breeding. They argue that the animals, they must have proper human-like care. Unko usi tarha care milni chahiye jis tarha humans apni care karte hain, so that unki protection ho sake, unko properly conserve kiya ja sake aur unki habitat ko maintain kiya ja sake.